They get one lap to check out the racetrack here. They call it a siding lap, and then we will stage up for heat race number one. We have two Pro Twins heat races. There'll be six laps the distance, top seven to the main event. We'll have three expert heat races. We'll take the top two to the dash and the top four to the main event. Then we'll have our first scheduled intermission. Come back with our Pro Twins last chance qualifier. Expert Dash for Cash, two expert semifinals, our second scheduled intermission, and then we'll have our Pro Twins main event, 18 riders, 12 laps, and our expert twin main event, 18 riders, 25 laps, 25 miles around the Springfield Mile. It is time to send them around for one lap to check out the track, and then we'll introduce the starting lineup for Pro Twins heat race number one. Pole sitter took the outside, so we'll wait until they get taken off and we'll give you the starting lineup.
Here is Scotty Dubler with your starting lineup for Pro Heat number one.
On the pole, ladies and gentlemen, from Mount Gillian, Ohio, he won here in May on the 17F, Jared Vandekoy. In the number two starting spot on the Harley-Davidson for Sylvester Farms, that's the 24J, Brandon Wilhelm. Third starting spot on the front row from Sherwood, Oregon, the Walrath Racing Kawasaki 16M, Austin Helmholtz. Starting fourth from Barrington, New Hampshire, 27U, Jameson Miner. Starting fifth from Grand Rapids, Michigan, 32C, Brian McRoberts. Last bike on the front row is the 34F, Andrew Butler, Cincinnati, Ohio. Row number two, the 17C, Sean McNary. 11G, Gary Ketchum. 57A, Ryan Connolly. And the 11F, Curtis Vandekoy. That is your starting lineup. The pole sitter has picked the outside of the front row. And we're getting set to start the Springfield Mile 2014 Labor Day edition. Special thanks to our local sponsors, Green Toyota, Miller Lite, and Memphis Shades, proud sponsors of the Springfield Mile weekend. Bikes are staged up now. First row has six, back row has four. 10-second board will go up, and she will turn that thing sideways. There's a Christmas tree down there. It's got one red light, two yellow lights, and then we go green. Here we go, ladies and gentlemen, at Springfield. Long light, and they're off. McRoberts wins the wheelie contest. Vandekoy will lead him into turn number one. So it's Vandekoy grabbing a hole shot. McRoberts definitely pulled the front wheel all the way down the front straightaway. Second is Wilhelm. So it's Jared Vandekoy. He won here in May. He's trying to check out early in heat race number one. They'll take him down the back straightaway for the first time. It is Vandekoy at the point. 24J of Wilhelm in second. This is Pro Twins heat race number one. Top seven finishers go to the main event out of this one. Into the third turn, here they come back as the sun's starting to poke out. It's a little bit warmer than 80 degrees for you folks listening in at home on fanschoice.tv. Here's your leader. We'll let you listen to him the first time by. All the bikes go blasting by. It's Vandekoy now. Wilhelm sets his sights on the leader. Wilhelm's catching up to the leader down there in turns one and two. Vandekoy definitely looked like he had this place dialed in practice. Now he's slipping up a little bit. Here comes Brandon Wilhelm on the Kawasaki. Butler now in the fourth spot on the 34F. The Cincinnati, Ohio riders catching up to third place. Last time by, Helmholtz was in third. Leader still the 17F, Jared Vandekoy, the Ohio rider out front. He'll bring him back this direction. Second place riders on the Harley-Davidson. This is Pro Twins. Here they come. Vandekoy still out front. Wilhelm still in the number two spot. Battle deeper in the field. Two laps complete here in heat race number one. Looks like Wilhelm's applying the pressure. Looks like he gets through turns one and two a little bit better than our leader. Now he's going to start up there and catch it, see if he can catch the draft. Vandekoy says not so fast. He pulls away just a little bit down the back chute. It is Vandekoy, the white motorcycles, easy to spot out there, the 17F. Here comes Wilhelm. Wilhelm's making it through the corners a little bit better than Vandekoy so far. Wilhelm's got some momentum coming up in turn number four. Here they come down the front straightaway. Vandekoy and Wilhelm. Wilhelm shows, swings out, tries to make the draft pass. Vandekoy shuts the door. So still Vandekoy out front. Wilhelm in second. Third is Helmholtz. Fourth is Butler. McRoberts is in the fifth spot. Gary Ketchum in sixth. And Jameson Miner right now is in our seventh and final transfer spot. But that's changing. Coming up for turn number two. They're three wide down the backstretch. Battle for the lead. Still getting tight. Actually pulled away just a little bit. Vandequay's got a little bit more breathing room. Kevin Clark, the best flag man in the business, pulls out the white and the green. That means he's going to show them two laps to go. He'll signal these riders as they go past the start-finish line. There's Vandequay, Wilhelm, Helmholtz, Butler. In three wide right there for fourth, fifth, and, for fifth, sixth, and seventh. That's the last transfer spot. They were three wide across the line. Still Vandequay, Wilhelm, Helmholtz, Butler, McRoberts, your top five. Jamison Minor, Gary Ketchum in that seventh and final transfer spot. That's where all the action is. One rider slips wide, goes up there right by the wall. I believe that was Ketchum, so he loses a little bit of ground down there off of turn number two. Leader's got about 10 bike lengths over the second place rider. So we have Kawasaki out front, Harley in the second spot. Then a bunch of Kawasaki's third, fourth, fifth, sixth, and seventh. Here's Vandequay, one more lap to go. It's Vandequay, Wilhelm. Helmholtz back there in the third spot. Behind him is Butler in fourth. And then things changed that last time by. Jamison Minor showing in fifth, Ryan Conley in sixth, and that right now it's Mick Roberts in the seventh spot. He is the final man on the bubble. Kevin Clark pulls out the checkered flag. We're going to end heat race number one in about a quarter of a lap. Vandequay is in control of this one. The 17F going to be coming back this way. Here comes Vandequay in the lead. Second is Wilhelm. Checkered flag flies. Vandequay is becoming a repeat customer at the checkered flag early. As they go across the start finish, and I watch them battle for seventh. Kevin Clark had to step out of the way for that guy. And there's Vandequay to wrap up. So we got Vandequay first and last, Jared and Curtis. Jared Vandequay picking up the win by almost a full second over Brandon Wilhelm second, Austin Helmholtz third, Andrew Butler fourth on the 34F, Jamison Minor fifth, Ryan Conley will get the sixth spot, and Brian McRoberts will get seventh on the 32C. So Sean McNary, Gary Ketchum, and Curtis Vandequay will all head to a semifinal. They are selling 50-50 tickets. Half of the money goes to the winning ticket holder. The other half will go to the Class of 79 and Friends trying to raise money to help out any riders who get injured in our sport, which is flat track motorcycles. They've opened up a gate all the way down there. Jared has to come on by, make the hard left-hand turn, and head up the ramp to meet my partner, Barry Boone. He's getting everything situated up there. Vandequay on that Kawasaki said he's got that thing dialed in. Johnny's Vintage Motorcycle, Dave Cycles, Scott Drummond, and he mentioned also earlier Tommy Duma. So the winner's coming up to the victory podium, and we'll throw it trackside in just a moment. And Mike's on. Let's go trackside with Barry Boone.
I tell you what, Scotty, he's fifth in points. He has been so strong this year, winning at Grays Harbor, winning at Indy Mile, and looking like he's on a path here today. Ladies and gentlemen, give it up for Pro Twins winner number one, Jared Vandequay. Wow, way to make it look easy, Jared. Get out there and do it.
Yeah, it was very slick that time. The track prep's really good. It's nice and smooth. Brandon Wilhelm's going to be fast in the main event. We know he's going to be right there. But, yeah, I just had to put my head down. I got a good start and sled it all.
I know you want to say thanks to some folks.
Yeah, I'd like to thank my mom and dad for getting this bike for me and Woody Kyle and Ben Evans for building it and 26 suspension, everybody for coming out, Tom Duma, Fine Jewelers, Fairway Ford, Dave Seigel, Al Hessen, Gary Manos, Ronald's Tree Service, Scott Drummond, and Warden Cycle.
He's one of those fast kids from Ohio, ladies and gentlemen. The future is bright with this young man coming up through the ranks. Give it up for Jared Vandequay.
This is your starting lineup for Pro Heat 2.
On the pole, ladies and gentlemen, from Belleville, Ohio, riding the Harley-Davidson 72F, Tyler Butts. From Bucyrus, Ohio, last week's winner on the 24F entry, J.R. Addison. From Freeland, Maryland, 35S, Dalton Winkler. From Monton, Pennsylvania, that's the 68A, that is Ryan Varnes. From Creve Coeur, Illinois, the 11P, Miss Molly Terry. Last rider on the front row, from St. Louisville, Ohio, the 23F, Jeffrey Lowry. Back in row number two, 33P Levi Mayer, 10L Mac McGrew on the Honda RS750, 74F Barry Bickert Jr., and the 55L Cole King, Burlington, Iowa on the Aprilia. So Mac McGrew was late to staging, so he is back there on the penalty line. Here we go, Pro Twins, heat race number two, six bikes on the front row, three on row number two, one bike on the back. Top seven finishers go directly to the main event. Everybody else goes to a last chance qualifier. Staged up, ready to go. Can't see the Christmas tree from my point of view, about halfway up the grandstands. White is green and they're off. Winkler pulls the front wheel outside his butts. Cole King comes up through the middle on the Aprilia. Gets a shot through there. Barnes is out there on the yellow and white leathers. Winkler had the early lead, gave it up already. New Rider's going to take the lead off of turn two. They're three wide for second place. They're stretching out down the backside. Here they come, getting into full song now. Tucked in and drafted and trying to get under the paint. Look at all these riders side by side into turn three. Hang on. Pro Twins down there in turn number three. They're going to come back at us. They're all in one pack. Here they come off of turn number four. I believe Winkler still has the lead. They're going to head back this direction. We'll let you listen to them the first time by. It is Winkler with the lead. Jeffrey Lowry now goes into the lead. The 23F, the Horizon Award winner, goes into the lead. Butts is out there on the 72F. I believe he pulled into the third spot. They'll come up for turn number two, get as small as they can down the back straightaway, use the draft to the best of their ability. Last time by, Butts was in third. Barnes was in fourth. Molly Terry was in the fifth spot. New Rider coming up there, taking over the lead. Bright orange helmet. We'll figure out who that is. Looks like Tyler Butts a little bit off the edge of the groove. Now he gets back down there into the third spot. Here they come off of four. They start fanning out early. Look at them. Three, now four wide, now back to two wide. It's Jeffrey Lowry, Dalton Winkler, Ryan Barnes, the 68A. Ryan Barnes out there, the 68A, now moves up there into the two spot. That is Reverend Kevin Barnes' son. That's Ryan Barnes. Now here comes another rider on the red motorcycle making his way towards the front. We'll figure out who that is in just a few moments as they'll come back by us. Now the new leader down the back straightaway. Barnes uses the draft. Winkler thinks about coming with them. Jeffrey Lowry slides back to second. Winkler is in the third spot. Your new leader, it is Reverend Ryan Barnes. Barnes going to lead him up a turn number two from Monton, Pennsylvania. Got a little bit sideways coming off a four. Here comes everybody else. Barnes, Lowry, Winkler, Molly Terry up to the four spot. Behind Molly Terry is J.R. Addison, new leader into turn number one. Dalton Winkler from Freeland, Maryland. 35S on his number plate will lead him off of turn number two. Second is Jeffrey Lowry. Third is Tyler Butts. Here comes Molly Terry. Look how small she gets down the back straightaway. She's in fourth place looking for some more. Right behind her is J.R. Addison, the 24F who won last week. Trying to tame this beast right here that made him crash down the front straightaway in practice here in May. He's trying to retaliate. He's up to fourth and looking for some more. Two laps to go. Here they come by the start-finish line. It is Lowry, Winkler, Barnes, Addison, and Molly Terry. Top seven finishers will all make the main event. It is now Winkler out front. Jeffrey Lowry in the second spot. J.R. Addison now in the third spot. And Ryan Barnes is in fourth and Molly Terry in fifth. They'll freight train down the back straightaway. Now they're spreading out, making some passes. They're side by side down the back chute. Here comes Jeffrey Lowry Jr., the former Horizon Award winner at the amateur ranks, moving up to pro, and now he's leading this one. 23F from Ohio will lead him off of turn number four to the white flag. One more lap around the Springfield Mile. Here they come. They're fanning out early. It is Winkler in the lead. Second, Jeffrey Lowry. Third is J.R. Addison. Molly Terry now in the fourth spot. Looks like Ryan Barnes is ducked into the fifth position. Here they come down the back chute. Addison makes the move around the outside, trying to make the pass. Maybe pulled out a little bit too soon. Now here comes Molly Terry looking for third. Here goes Jeffrey Lowry to the lead. That will slide Winkler back to second. Molly Terry's looking for third place. Here they come. Final corner. Heat race number two of the Pro Twins. It's Jeffrey Lowry, Dalton Winkler, Molly Terry up to third place. Can't she make the draft pass? Here they come. Here comes Winkler. Here comes Molly. Yeah. From my point of view, it looked like she had it. We'll wait till one more rider goes on by. Ladies and gentlemen, from Creve Coeur, Illinois, the 11P, Molly Terry pulls off the win with the last lap pass. She won by .021 seconds over Dalton Winkler second, Jeffrey Lowry third, Ryan Barnes fourth, J.R. Addison gets the fifth spot. Mac McGrew puts the Honda in, and Levi Mayer will take that seventh and final spot. So I'm not sure what happened to Tyler Butts, but he finishes eighth. Ninth will go to Barry Binker Jr., and Cole King on that Aprilia will finish in the 10th spot. We're going to have a very happy young lady from Creve Coeur, Illinois. She's got a host of sponsors, but, man, how'd you like that one, Barry?
Oh, man, you know what? You asked the right question, but I'm going to ask these people. All right, Springfield, how'd you like that mile? That's what I'm talking about. Scotty, we've got to come up with a new term because we've got all these fast boys from Illinois that for a decade we've been referring to as the FBI. And this young lady's from Illinois, and she's not a B. She's a G, so we're going to have to come up with a little bit of a nomenclature change on that. We're going to ask her to ride that big machine right up this ramp right here, and she can do it. Molly Terry from Creve-Coeur, Illinois, has done it. She's found the top of the box here at Springfield, ladies and gentlemen. What a great ride here today for Molly on this beautiful XR750. I dare say it may be the proudest moment of her career to date right now. She's just going to sit right there. Ladies and gentlemen, Springfield, your Pro Twins Heat winner, Molly Terry. Molly, great race. Talk to us about how it felt to ride that XR at Springfield.
Well, this bike has a lot of power, and you can definitely feel it. Just learning the power of the draft is everything here, and that's what I did end up doing, and that's how I got by. I'm right at the start-finish line, and I just couldn't be happier.
And now you're front row of the Pro Twins main. It's got to be exciting, and I know you want to say thanks to a bunch of folks.
Yeah, I definitely want to say a big thanks to my parents. If it wasn't for them, I wouldn't be here. B&B Racing, Galen, Foundry Rats Motorcycle Club, Peoria TT, Wiseco, Arai Helmets, Bikers PhD, just everybody, the fans, everyone that helped me get here, I want to thank them all.
She's part of the FGI, the Fast Girls from Illinois, ladies and gentlemen. Number 11, Molly Terry. Hollywood, it's all you. It's time for some experts.
For the first of three expert heats, here's your starting lineup for Expert Heat 1.
Your fast qualifier, ladies and gentlemen, the factory Harley-Davidson motorcycle from Eatonville, Washington. Number one, the Bullet, Brad Baker. From Clio, Michigan, number nine, Jared Meese. From Morris, Connecticut, number two, Kenny Coolbeth Jr. From Graham, Washington, number seven, Slammin' Sammy Halbert. From Ocampo, California, the factory Triumph, number 91, Mikey Martin. And from Edmond, Oklahoma, making his return back to the Springfield Mile, 74G, Ronnie Jones. Row number two, 96B, Cody Johncox, 82, Jeremy Higgins, 28P, Michael Bickerton, 30S, Jason Eisenach, 16, Wyatt McGuire, 64C, Jerry Steele. On row number three, 88G, Kent Briggs, 25, Kevin Anderson. Top two finishers, ladies and gentlemen, go to the Dash for Cash. The top four finishers all go directly to today's 25-lap Grand National Main Event. Keep your eyes on the Bullet. Brad Baker looking to get back on track. Broke his elbow earlier this season, trying to make his way back to the top of the box. Points leader was last week was Jared Meese on the nine. Now Brian Smith is currently your points leader. Meese is in the second spot in the points. Here we go, and the track's ready. We'll turn them loose. Track's clear. The lenses are coming down. Grand National Experts, here we go. Heat race number one. Top two to the Dash for Cash, top four to the Grand National Main Event. And they are off. Albert on the Kawasaki from the middle gets his hole shot. Coolbeth from the outside is going to try to tuck into the second place. It's a new rider in second. We'll figure out who that is, possibly Coolbeth. Coolbeth right there in the second spot. We've got some red leathers back there in third. That's Oklahoma's own Ronnie Jones. Meese in the fourth spot. It's slamming. Sammy Albert down the back straightaway. I believe it is Coolbeth up there battling for the lead. Here they come down the back chute. New rider taking over the lead. Slide Halbert back to second place. Look at one rider going three, now four wide up there in the high stuff. That's Kevin Atherton style. We'll figure out who that is in just a moment. Wow, somebody went all the way around the outside and found the high line. That's the Bullet, Brad Baker. So the Bullet, Brad Baker goes all the way around. One rider down in turn number one into the air fence. Red light will come out. One rider down into turn number one into the air fence by himself. Red flags, red lights are flashing down the back straight. Kevin Clark takes off down the front straightaway to try to slow him down. There's red flashing lights all the way around the racetrack. Not sure who went down, but he's kind of up into the air fence. Trying to get these bikes slowed down as fast as we can. Here comes the number two, Kenny Coolbeth. Hasn't checked up just yet. We got one rider down. He's up there into the air fence, right out there at the Dunlop air fence. So we got one rider down. Didn't see what happened. We We're getting a down rider checked out. 28P, it is Itchy. Michael Bickerton, he was up there shown in the seventh spot as he went by the start-finish line. Itchy is the 28P from Alexis, Illinois, the RRCF Racing entry. He's kind of stuck underneath the air fence, but they said he is all right. The motorcycle's smoking a little bit. It looks like it's a little bit pissed off. So don't put me on the ground like that. Itchy said, I'm all right. Just get this air fence off of me. So 28P, Michael Bickerton out of Alexis, Illinois, riding a Suzuki SV650. That is a liquid-cooled motorcycle. Looks like it's steaming out the right side now. So trying to make sure everybody's all right, but definitely a wild ride going down. That's why the air fence is there, to take care of these riders, to keep them from getting into the guardrail or the wall or anything up there. It's a safety that we've added the last few seasons, but right into the Dunlop air fence, all the rest of the motorcycles will gather up down there in the hot box. And in the heat races and the main events, just like all the rest of the races, you're not allowed to work on the motorcycles, but you are allowed to add tear-offs if you need to. Grab yourself something to eat, something to drink. What did you think about Brad Baker going around the high line down there in 3 and 4, Kevin Atherton style? Man, what a move he made on lap number one. Not sure if he wanted me to tell all these other guys that are sitting over there by him what he did, but he found the high line and was making it work. They're still checking out down there on the 28P, Michael Bickerton. Obviously, it looked like the radiator or possibly a radiator hose was leaking as it was steaming as it was coming straight off that motorcycle. I believe Itchy is up. We'll try to get the official word. He's climbing in the back of that mule. Is that right? So we're going to send him back around. We're trying to get the crash truck out there to pick up. That's the green Toyota crash truck, they call it. He's going head out there and pick up that motorcycle that went down. Special thanks to green Toyota for providing the crash truck.
And, you know, Scotty, today will be a big day for us. Some lucky fan is going to go home with a brand new Harley-Davidson. Thanks to A-Bait of Illinois. We'll give that away during the final 10-minute break before we go to our Pro Twins and expert main events. We're going to be giving it away.
Very Itchy. Michael Bickerton's right here in this orange vehicle coming down the first row. Let's put our hands together for Michael Bickerton from Alexis, Illinois. He's right here in this one getting the ride back. He's all right. He's waving to you folks right there. Gutteridge taking him back to the pit area. Special thanks to them. Looks like he is A-OK. Got trapped underneath the air fence over there. Those things are heavy. Looks like Steve Moorhead's going to push that motorcycle back around, so evidently doesn't seem like it's too tore up. I don't know if they'll probably scratch him for this one. He just climbs out of that vehicle. He's over talking some things over, talking to a few guys over there in the turn number four. I think he's just trying to make dinner arrangements for later, possibly.
And Scotty, he could go theoretically to a backup motorcycle, I believe.
That's exactly what they're talking about on the radio right now. They'll take that transponder off of that bike. They said, go get it. Let's fire it up. So Itchy's, he's already putting his helmet back on. He's going to get that backup motorcycle. They'll take that transponder off of the fork tube, off that primary bike, and he's going to go get on his backup bike. He will start at the tail end of the field if he's going to try to make this start. So that's pretty cool that they can do that.
After going into the air fence at about 120 or 115 or 20 miles an hour, that's a good thing and a testimonial to the air fence. And, of course, right here at the yellow and white checkered flag finish line, there is a loop buried under this racetrack, and that transponder that Scotty's talking about, every time they go by, it trips, and the computers update immediately. And you can get that updated scoring on your smartphone right now by going to the Marketplace or the App Store and downloading the free or 99-cent premium app from the App Store or the Marketplace. You can have timing and scoring not only at the round you're at, but at any round, anytime, that you want to tune in on AMA program National Flat Track Action.
Also, for your fans that are joining us here today, if you're not going to make the West Coast swing, be sure and watch it on fanschoice.tv. It is free. They're watching it at home and all around the world right now at fanschoice.tv, keeping up with the action here at the Springfield Mile. So Bickerton looks like he was unhappy with one or two of the riders just a little bit ago, pointed his fingers at him, but now he's climbed on his backup bike. He's sitting back there all by himself. So he evidently spoke his mind. Now he's ready to go racing.
And our West Coast swing is September 27th. We'll be in the wine country at Calistoga Half Mile. The track was undamaged by the recent earthquake, but we understand most of the wineries out there were heavily impacted by it. Many thousands of bottles of great wine were destroyed during the earthquake. It was a 6-plus magnitude right there in the heart of the wine country. So our thoughts are with the Ramspur Winery folks and all the other great vineyards out there in the wine country region. And then the final race of the year is the Flat Track Finals at Pomona.
That's coming up on October the 11th. We'll have our awards ceremony the following day on October 12th. And then the 2014 season will be in the record book. Hard to believe, Hollywood, that we are already down to three to go counting this one.
Absolutely. The delay right now, folks, is there's a little bit of moisture, obviously, where the radiator was leaking up there. It's way off the groove, but you know what? Brad Baker is running that high over there in turns three and four, so we can't say that the motorcycle won't be up that high. So they're treading, putting a little bit of loose dirt on top of the moisture and working it in over there. So it looks like they're all leaving the scene right now. So we should be able to fire up these motorcycles. We'll have a complete restart in just a moment. You can see the teams are down there. Most of the riders still have their helmets strapped on. And 28P did jump onto the backup motorcycle. He will start the tail end of the field. And that is Itchy from Alexis, Illinois. That is Michael Bickerton, RRCF Racing, Royce Taylor Racing, DCT Precision, and Motorcycle Superstore. I know Barry's always joking with these guys, but you'll hear all their sponsors either if they win or if they crash. So we had to give a shout out to all of the 28P's sponsors. So backup bike is coming out, so we are ready to go in just a moment. They're going to send them out. We'll fire them up once again. Heat race number two. Actually, Expert heat race number one, I'm sorry. We'll take the top two to the Dash for Cash and the top four directly to the main event. Here they come. They stick the starters in the side cases of these motorcycles and fire them up and bring them to life. The factory Harley number one pulls them out first. He's got all white leathers on with the Harley stripe across the chest. Let's see which bike he's riding. He's riding the orange one. A couple of different ones. They got Black Beauty back there. This is the orange number one bike. That's the Bullet, Brad Baker. Jared Meese will pull up second on the number nine. Pole sitter picks either outside or inside in the heats, in the semi, and in the dash. And then we get to the main event. You get your pick on the line. Jack Coolbeth, Jared Meese. So let's start from the outside. We got Baker, Jared Meese, Coolbeth, Sammy Halbert on the Kawasaki, Mikey Mark 91 on the Triumph. And how about Ronnie Jones, ladies and gentlemen, 53 years old on the 74G, trying to make the main event. He's already made a main event in five different decades. He made his first Grand National main event in the 70s. He made mains in the 80s, 90s, 2010s, and last year right here in the 2013 made the main event on that motorcycle he's riding today, Salina Harley-Davidson entry. Ronnie Jones, the 74G, he was number 16 for as long as I can remember, about 22 years. Here we go, ladies and gentlemen, complete restart, heat race number one. Baker gets the hole shot on the outside. Here comes Meese. Now Baker misses the gear. Baker's still having trouble getting it into the right gear. Looks like he's got it pointed the right way, but he's third from the last. So Baker's at the tail end of the field. Looks like Meese is going to lead him off of two. Coolbeth is right there. Sammy Halbert in the third spot. Fourth, I believe, is Mikey Martin. Fifth is Ronnie Jones. They'll take him down the back straightaway at about 135 miles an hour. Three wide, almost going into three. New leader into turn number three. Look how deep the leader went into turn number three. Meese says, let me see. I'll sit back here and watch for a second. He's back in second. Green flag's going to fly. We'll let you listen to him the first time by at full song. So Baker's now up to full speed. He was third from the back. Now he's made himself away from the back markers, working his way towards the front. He's in about seventh. Off of tournament two, it's the King of Cool, Kenny Coolbeth, trying to check out. We got Meese in second. Third is Sammy Halbert. Fourth, Ronnie Jones. Fifth back there is Mikey Martin. Wyatt McGuire, the Rookie of the Year leader, is right there in the sixth spot. And then here comes the Bullet. Brad Baker is up to seventh from getting a terrible start and then missing a gear. Baker trying to catch up to the leaders. Off of four, it's Kenny Coolbeth. Jared Meese, 1-2. Sammy Halbert in third. Ronnie Jones in fourth. Wyatt McGuire. Mikey Martin. Brad Baker. Ronnie Jones has to throw it sideways. Sammy Doerr shuts the door on Ronnie Jones. Ronnie had to throw it completely sideways. It cost him a spot. Now he gets back in line in the fifth spot. So Sammy Halbert's back there in third. Now Wyatt McGuire is in the fourth spot. He's number 16. He goes after seven. So two Washington riders battling for third and fourth. McGuire takes over the third spot. Ronnie Jones shows the wheel up there on Sammy Halbert for fifth. Back out front, it's Coolbeth on the number two. Harley Davidson doing it for Zanotti Racing. Jared Meese in second, number nine. Ryan McGuire, Sammy Halbert, Ronnie Jones, Mikey Martin, Brad Baker, and the rest of the riders go blasting by the start-finish line. Last time by, Kenny Coolbeth was out front by almost a half a second. So it's Coolbeth in the lead. He gets down and tucks in as small as he can early off of turn number two, gets his feet on the pegs early. It's Coolbeth, Meese. Wyatt McGuire in the third spot, securely into a main event spot. He's doing the Weirbach Racing Kawasaki today. He said he blew up his Kawasaki back home on the dyno, so let me borrow a bike. Weirbach said, yes, sir, come on. That time off of turn number four, Sammy Halbert had a lot of head shake. Ronnie Jones had to check up once again for fourth and fifth is where it's tight. Your leader is Cool Beth. Second is me. So little ways back to Wyatt McGuire in third. Then we got fourth, fifth, and sixth. Here comes Mikey Martin on the 91 Triumph. He goes blasted by Ronnie Jones. He's now caught up to Sammy Halbert on that Kawasaki. Looks like the man on the move right now is the 91. Mikey Martin, that's the Triumph. The track's starting to take some rubber down now as the sun is out in full. Oh, Halbert gets some more head shake off of four. Mikey Martin has gone on by Halbert. Ronnie Jones stuck behind him. Five laps in the books here. Heat race number one, top two will go to the dash. Top four to the main. Cool Beth's starting to check out. He's got about a little bit more than a half a second lead. Is Cool Beth at the point, side by side for third, fourth, and now fifth. Here they come. Slide Ronnie Jones back at spot or two. Out front, Cool Beth, your leader, bringing him off a turn before. Two laps to go this time by. Michael Bickerton took the 28P back to the pit area. There's Cool Beth. Meese in second. Now we got anybody's race. We got Mikey Martin, Wyatt McGuire, Sammy Albert's there. Brad Baker's caught up to these guys. Baker now is in the fifth spot. Remember, he went absolutely nowhere up to start. He's up to fifth. He needs one more spot to make the main. Baker was third from last in turn number one. Now he's working his way towards the front. He's right there with Sammy Halbert and Wyatt McGuire. So three Washington riders trying to take that fourth spot. Four riders to the main event. Here comes your leader coming back this direction. It is still the King of Cool, Kenny Cool Beth Jr. Meese in second, Mikey Martin third. Fourth is Halbert, fifth is the Bullet Brad Baker. He tucks in behind Sammy. Baker has caught the leaders, that's for sure. The best battle on the track is for third, fourth, fifth, and sixth. Ronnie Jones back there in the seventh spot off of the draft now. Last lap, here comes Cool Beth in turns three and four. He's definitely on a mission. Do it for Zanotti Racing, Monroney's Harley-Davidson. Here he comes off a four to win heat race number one. It is the King of Cool, Kenny Cool Beth Jr. Meese will get second. Third is Mikey Martin, fourth is Sammy Halbert, so the Bullet doesn't quite make the pass. As the timing and scoring just keeps updating right in front of me, Kenny Cool Beth Jr. on the Zanotti Harley takes the win by 1.6 seconds over Jared Meese. Meese and Cool Beth will take the transfers to the dash for cash. Mikey Martin puts the Triumph in the main. Sammy Halbert takes that fourth spot away. So Sammy Halbert will be your fourth transfer to the main event, and he's on the Kawasaki. Brad Baker, Wyatt McGuire, Ronnie Jones, Cody Johncox, Jeremy Higgins, Jerry Steele, 10th, Jason Eisenach, 11th, Kent Briggs, 12th, Kevin Anderson, 13th, and Michael Bickerton down four laps, scores the 14th spot. There's your winner, Kenny Cool Beth. And he's got to make that hard left-hand turn and then head up the ramp to meet my partner and the Harley-Davidson girls, but they're missing in action.
Yeah, you know what, Scotty? This guy's having a year. He won down at Daytona Flat Track 2 on his singles bike. He came back to that hot, that clay fast oval at Knoxville, Iowa, and he won there early in the season. He actually had the point lead for a while, and he's back in it right now. The Zanotti team giving him a great piece of equipment to ride. There's not a speck of dirt on this motorcycle. That's how you do it. You get out front and ride away from them. You keep your motorcycle clean. You know who I'm talking about, ladies and gentlemen. He's fourth in points. He's the King of Cool, Kenny Cool Beth Jr. Great ride. It has to feel good.
Yeah, we struggled there in practice. I felt all right, but we made a bunch of changes. The track actually came around to us, and we just need to get away like that in the main event, and we'll be all right.
Speaking of the main, now you're front row of the main. You're in the dash for cash. That's a great way to start your Springfield, too.
Yeah, Springfield's great. You know, the fans here, it's just awesome. No rain, so looking forward to a good main event and a dash for cash, and support the people that support me, you know, Zanotti, Maroney's Harley-Davidson, Top One Oil, DC. I know he's watching right now, and thank you for all your help.
All right, Kenny Cool Beth Jr.'s front row of the main, ladies and gentlemen. Make some noise one more time.
Here is how we will start them in expert heat race number two.
On the pole of heat race number two, the number 42 from Flint, Michigan, on the Kawasaki is Brian Smith. Starting second from Coatesville, Pennsylvania, number five, Jersey Jake Johnson. From Clio, Michigan, the racing lady, number 15, Nicole Meese. From Mossville, Illinois, on the KTM, 27, Robbie Pearson. From Claremont, Indiana, riding a Buell motorcycle here today is the 31, Dan Ingram. And last rider on the front row on the KTM from Mechanicsburg, Pennsylvania, 32, Sean Baer. Row number two, 65, Corey Texter, 61, Dustin Crow, 44, Brandon Robinson, 74, Pete Chaz Landers, 20T, Mikey LaBelle, 21, Duke Erickson, and the 13X, Ken Maynard. That is your starting lineup, expert heat race number two. Top two to the Dash for Cash, top four will all go directly to the main event. This is our second qualifying heat race. Coolbeth looks like he's definitely on his way to possibly winning his fourth Springfield Mile. He's won here three times before. They're lined up and ready to go with heat race number two. Brian Smith on the outside, that black Kawasaki. Crossley Radio, the sponsor. Number five, Jake Johnson pulls up on his Kawasaki. 15, Nicole Meese on the Black Hills Harley-Davidson. Shout out to Mel, who didn't get to make it out here from Black Hills Harley. Melanie Reimer's listening in at home. 27, Robbie Pearson, the leader of the FBI, the Fast Boys from Illinois, starting fourth. Dan Ingram, Sean Baer, here we go. They are off, ladies and gentlemen. It's Johnson to lead him into number one. I got Sean Baer on the inside. Sean Baer, now Robbie Pearson to lead. Now here comes Brian Smith around the outside. Smith takes the lead on the 42 Kawasaki. Robbie Pearson takes the KTM into second. I believe Jake Johnson is in the third spot. Down the back straightaway they go. They're two, now three wide, now two wide. Back there, here comes Robbie Pearson to lead him into turn number three. Pearson is your leader. They're three wide in the middle of the corner. Somebody's completely sideways. Here they come now. Oh, one rider down. Now the other rider into the hay bales and goes down. Red flag is out. They'll shut him down. So the good news is both riders hopped up immediately. Bad news is there's hay bales all over the racetrack down there. So that got exciting in a hurry. So one rider goes down. That's Dan Ingram with the bright yellow helmet. He's up and okay. Another rider got clipped and went up there into the hay bales. He's up and okay. He's taking his helmet off and he's trying to gather himself. So we'll see who's down. I know the one rider is Ingram. We know Ingram on the 31 is up. He appears to be okay. Trying to figure out who the other rider is as the Kymco scooters are already there. The one rider's walking around a little bit. 74P, I'm sorry, 74P, Chaz Landers, one of the riders that are down, 74P, and the 31. 74P, Chaz Landers out of Auburn, Illinois, doing it for Anders Racing, Loose Cycle, AME Grips, and the 31. Dan Ingram borrowing a motorcycle. He's got a Buell. It's got Danny Harsma and Clint Erickson, Zana Racing, these sponsors on that 31 Buell. Dan Ingram's good to see him out here, but not the way he wanted to finish heat race number one. He's getting a push back already. Everybody else pulls up to the hot box. This is heat race number two. So it looks like we'll have just a short moment. We're going to need some hay bales up there to move those around. Both riders appear to be up. Let's put our hands together for both of our riders. Ingram back on the motorcycle. He's headed back over here. And Chaz Landers, the 74P, going down over there in turn number four. I believe both riders are okay. They're trying to get the hay bales taken care of, and that is why we have the hay bales. And in the first heat race, that's why we have the air fence. So they're getting everything taken care of down there in turn number four. One of the guys from the class of 79 is up here, Charlie Roberts. Charlie Roberts, I know part of the reason you're involved with the class of 79 friends is for instances just like this. It looks like both these riders are okay, but the class of 79 had a huge party last night. Was it a success?
Absolutely, Scotty. It was a great success. Want to thank all the people that came out and supported what we did. Scotty, I told you yesterday, there's a family here. A gentleman named Jim Trader was a long time. His family is a motorcycle dealer here in Springfield. Jim was a long time volunteer and supporter here at the Springfield Mile. We just want to say a special condolence to Jim Trader and his family. Godspeed, Jim. I guess he's been sick with cancer and didn't tell anybody, and he passed last Wednesday. But wanted to give a shout out to the family. Back to what you were saying, what we just seen right here is the exact reason that we do what we do. We help everybody that gets hurt. We hope these guys are okay, but sometimes they're not. I don't have a final tally on the party yet, so I don't want to say. I thought the Ride the Mile was a huge success with the legends leading it. It's pretty fun to get back out there on an XR750. I kind of tucked in and elbowed Jaybird a little bit, so love that stuff, man.
That was pretty cool. $10 to ride the mile. We're going to do it again in May. Hopefully, it'll go to the Class 79 again, but A-Bait was a big part of that. Part of that went to the Class 79 friends. You guys have already given away $35,000. Barry's got something to track.
I just want to jump in, guys, real quick. Don't mean to interrupt, but a sec, but I'm caught up with number 31, Dan Ingram. Joe Baggett pulls up, says, "You do good, dude." He says, "Yes, I'm fine." So, Dan, tell us about your get-off down there. What happened, and how are you?
Well, I just got in there and got back on the gas, and the rear end jumped out real quick, and I just couldn't save it.
Yeah, so all's well with the motorcycle. You're good to go. Go back to action here in a sec.
Yeah, the front end's a little twisted. I want to thank Xana Racing, Denny Harsma, Clint Erickson. Thank you.
All right, that's Dollar Bill Racing's Dan Ingram. We call him the old man of the mountain. He is back, ladies and gentlemen, and he is good to go. Scotty, back up to you guys.
So the party was a huge success. Ride the mile. You told him that you wanted to have about 1,000 bikes. It looked like you had quite a few. I don't know if there's quite 1,000, but it took a little longer than we expected as we started our opening ceremonies a little bit late, but it all was for a good cause.
Absolutely, and it all goes to a 501(c) not-for-profit charity registered with the Internal Revenue Service. All dollars donated are 100% tax deductible. Hey, and then one more note. How about that old guy, number 64, last night?
Charlie Roberts rode the Bultaco Astra Cup, I believe, to a third or fourth place finish. Fourth, I believe, but he had fun out there. So, like I said, over $35,000. Most of the Class of 79 is here, with the exception, I think, Lance Jones, the only one's not here. Wayne Rainey, Charlie Roberts, I know Bubba Schobert's helping out. Scott Parker is helping out. A lot of folks are here. Let's go back trackside with Barry Boone.
Yeah, thanks, guys. Down here with national number 15, the racing lady, Nicole Mees. Nicole, you looked really good at the opening laps of that one. Now it's time to go back to work. How you feeling? How's the track? How's the bike?
The Black Hills Otten racing bike is working really good. You know, we've got a decent start and made up some time in the first two corners, and hopefully we can go out there, get another good start, and finish on top.
She loves this place. She has won some races here before, won a couple of dashes. She's won heat races. She's looking for that big win here today. And, Scotty, could it be that the racing lady from Clio, Michigan, could put her name in the record book as an Expert Twins winner? We'll find out this afternoon back up top.
I believe it definitely could happen. Looks like they're just about done with fixing all the hay up there. They've got the leaf blowers blowing the loose hay up there behind the other hay bales. They've got them stacked up and ready to go. We're going to try it once again here in just a second.
I'm going to chat with one more guy. I'll let you guys get on it. This is, of course, Brian Smith. He's been the hot hand on the miles of late. Brian, how you feeling today? How's the Crosley Radio bike working?
It's working great. We got to go to work right now.
He says, "Let me go to work, Barry. I got to get out here and try to win me one." Scotty, that's it from down here. They're firing them up.
They just told me on the AMA Pro Racing Radio it will be a complete restart, so we'll line them up just the way they were, with the exception of Ingram on the back. And if the other rider, 74 Pete Chaz Landers, can join us, he'll be on the back also. I don't know if he has a backup motorcycle or not, so we'll find out in a second. One of the boss men come up here in a suit. You got to take care of him, you know. Here comes Brian Smith. He'll bring out the Crosley Radio 42 bike he won last week at the Mega Mile. If you weren't there, he rolled the start. They put him back there on the fourth row. He was in seventh place off of turn number. And one more line, Brian. He's already trying to penalize himself today. He rolled the start last weekend to start on the fourth row, as well as Jake Johnson started back there too. They both made it to the podium, first and third place respectively. Well, I don't see the 74 piece, so a tough break for Chaz Landers. Not sure if he has a backup motorcycle or not, but the 74 P Chaz Landers, Anders Racing Loose Cycle, AME Grips, LP Management Company, and Hall's Harley-Davidson sponsors on that 74 P. Dan the man, Dan Ingram, picks his Buell back up that he was riding. He doesn't have a backup motorcycle, so I got to ride this one. He's got to finish in the top four spots to make the main event, so here we go. Heat race number two. Track's clear. We'll watch the Christmas tree. One red light, two yellows, and then we go green. They are off. Johnson on the outside, Bugs Pearson on the inside. So Johnson's going to lead him into one now. Brian Smith ducks into second. Pearson back to third. It looks like Nicole Mees right there in the fourth spot. So it's Jersey Jake Johnson. The five will lead him off of two. Smith in second. Robbie Pearson riding to KTM for the first time. He's in third. Nicole Mees back there in fourth. Here they come. They're three wide going into three. Pearson backs up. He said, "I'm not going to win this one on the first lap. I'll wait a second." They're going to bring him off of turn number four. Heat race number two, Grand National Experts. It is the Piper out front. Brian Smith will bring him off of four. Here they come. Here they come. First time by. Into the first corner, it's Johnson. Smith in second, Robbie Pearson third. Nicole Meese is right there in the fourth spot as they went by. Corey Texter was up to fifth from the back row. Brandon Robinson's up there also. He made a bike change. Whoa, one rider got all kinds of sideways. I believe that was Corey Texter. It set him straight up. They're too wide. Now they're too wide for third and fourth. Here they go into the corner. Smith back out front. Jake Johnson tucks into the number two spot. Third is Robbie Bugs Pearson on the 27 bike. Here they come back at us. It is the 42, the 5, now the 27, KTM coming to the front. Now Brandon Robinson is up there. Too tall, the tall drink of water from Oxford, Pennsylvania. Brandon Robinson, when we were here last, in the last year, Brandon Robinson went back-to-back wins. Now he's up to a transfer spot. He's looking for some more slide. Nicole Meese back to fifth. She's tucked in and drafting right behind Robinson. Here comes Johnson. Johnson takes the Lloyd Brothers Kawasaki to the lead. Slide Smith back to second. Still in third is Robbie Pearson on the 27 bike. He switched to the Waters Auto Body KTM for today's event. Here they come off of four, back down the front straightaway. Smith back out front. Johnson in second. Robbie Pearson third. Brandon Robinson fourth. Nicole Meese in the fifth spot. Sixth is Corey Texter, C-Tex on the 65, hanging on to the lead draft. Top six have broken away from everybody else. They get pointed in the right direction. It is Smith, Johnson. Here comes Robbie Pearson on the 27. He thought about it for a second. Looked like Jake Johnson dabbled his foot going into the corner. Looked like kicked back just a little bit. No harm, no foul. Let's keep on racing. Here comes your leader, 42 out front. It is Smith, Johnson trying to make the draft pass. Here he comes, he's setting him up. Robinson goes in there, takes that third spot away from the 27. One rider off the groove, going up high. He gets it slowed down just in time before he got up there into the air fence. So now we got six riders once again still broken away from everybody else. It's Johnson, Smith. Now here comes Brandon Robinson. So Kawasaki's first, second, and third. KTM back there in the fourth spot. They're to come back this direction. Lap number five will go in the books this time by. 42, flying Brian Smith. Number five, Jake Johnson in second. Third is the big 44, Brandon Robinson. Robbie Pearson in fourth, Nicole Meese in fifth. Corey Texter right there in the sixth spot. Six riders breaking away just a little bit. Down the back straightaway they go. It is Johnson on the 5, 42 Smith. Now here comes Brandon Robinson on the 44 bike. Now Smith says, I want to lead this one. He will take him into turn number 3. 42 out front, the Crosley Radio, Villa Esparza. I'll get that figured out before the season's over with, I promise. Two laps to go. Here comes your leader on the 42 bike. They take a different line. Watch out, Kevin Clark. Smith trying to shut the door. Johnson says not so fast. Now Robinson comes around the outside, takes that third spot away. So it's now Johnson, Robinson, and Smith down the back straightaway. Johnson, Brandon Robinson on the 44. Now here comes Brian Smith. Three wide momentarily into one, into three. Smith back out to the lead on the 42 bike. Smith wants to control it to the white flag. Setting up for one heck of a finish, the final lap. Top four of these riders will keep on racing into the main. Everybody else goes to a semi. 27 pulls out early. Robbie Pearson says, I want to get up there a little bit further. So now it's Smith, Robinson, Johnson, 1, 2, and 3. Bugs Pearson in fourth, Nicole Meese in fifth. Corey Texter's right there in the sixth spot. It's still anybody's ball game. They'll take him down the back straightaway. Brian Smith, a half a lap to go. Smith, now here comes Robinson. Johnson looks around the outside. Johnson going all the way around the outside. Third to first into turn number 3. Jersey Jake Johnson says, I want to lead him off of 4 for the final time. It is Jersey Jake Johnson on the 5. Here they come, tucked in and drafting. Who's going to pull out first? Johnson, Smith. Whew. Six riders battling for only 4 spots. So we'll give you just a second. Let a couple more bikes go by. So your 4 transfers look like this. Your heat race winner, number 42. Brian Brian Smith taking the win. Listen to this, by 0.004 seconds. So four thousandths of a second between first and second. Third spot, 44, Brandon Robinson. Fourth will be the Robbie Pearson machine, 27. He takes that last transfer spot. Nicole Meese, Corey Texter, Sean Baer, Justin Crow, Mikey LaBelle, 21 to Duke Erickson, Ken Maynard, Dan Ingram, and Chaz Landers will all be headed to a semifinal.
I got to ask him, Scotty, you know what to do. Hey, Springfield, how'd you like that ball? That is Springfield right there. You've got 5, 6, 7 riders all in the lead draft. But you've got to beat a man on a mile. This is a tough customer right here, the man in black, number 42. It's the Piper, Brian Smith. He is your point leader by 6 points. He won Springfield Mile here in May. He won Hagerstown. He won Sacramento Mile, doing it for the 4th consecutive time. Nobody in history has ever done that. And he won the Virginia Mega Mile and a Quarter here at our last round. And he's on target, perhaps, to dominate Springfield. And now it's your turn, Springfield, to make some noise. And I know you can't wait. National number 42, your heat race winner. Give it up for the Piper, Brian Smith. Brian, that's the kind of race you like to win, isn't it? When you got them all over you, two or three different guys challenging every lap.
Yeah, it's fun when it's a dogfight like that. I mean, as a racer, you always want to get out front and make it boring for the crowd. But it's going to be a fun main event and a fun dash for cash. Jake's fast, Brandon Robinson's fast, and Kenny Coolbad looked fast in that first one. So it's going to be a scrap. A
bunch of guys serve notice. They're also in the house here today at Springfield. I know you want to thank your team.
Yeah, I got to thank Crosley Radio via Sparza, Joe Sparza, for you know, doing everything they do. All the guys back in Indy, Jeff, Dink, Ricky, Heyman, everybody at Ricky's shop and Jeff's shop for and Dreyer's Honda for being behind me. Thanks a lot. And thanks to all the fans for coming out.
Brian Smith has won this race on a Harley and obviously on a Kawasaki. He's going to look to do it again today. One more time, Springfield, for the Piper, Brian Smith.
Let's roll your starting lineup for Expert Heat Race number 3.
Third and final heat race for the Expert Twins from Crystal, Michigan, the Dons Kawasaki 17, Henry Wiles. From Glenmore, Pennsylvania, on the 55, that's Jake Shoemaker, the USC Kawasaki. Starting third from Keller, Texas, the Harley-Davidson of Wausau entry, 59, Willie McCoy. Zanotti Racing Harley, number 80, Stevie Bonzi. Mississauga, Ontario, Canada, number 73, Dougie Fresh, Doug Lawrence. Starting in the fifth spot, starting sixth from Godfrey, Illinois, and the Dan Daffner Harley-Davidson, number 23, Jeffrey Carver, Jr. Back on row number 2, 49, Chad Coast, 93X, Danny Kelch, 74, Scooter Vernon, 47G, Colt Schabaltz, 25A, Shannon Texter, 46, Aaron Linfors, and on row number 3, 81G, is Brett Souders. Here we go, Expert Heat Race number 3, the final qualifying heat race of the afternoon. After this one, we'll take our first scheduled intermission since the last qualifying heat race, and we'll take our first intermission, come back with our last chance qualifier for the Pro Singles. Here we go. Wiles grabs the whole shot. McCoy's right there, the bright orange motorcycles. Hammer and Hank, Henry Wiles into turn number 1 first. Willie McCoy settles into the 2 spot. Shoemaker's up there in the 3rd spot. They're too wide for 3rd, 4th, and 5th. Now here they come. Carver comes through to the 4th place. Somebody's going backwards in a hurry. Carver's going forwards in a hurry. It is Wiles. Now here comes Wild. Willie McCoy up the inside. 2-time Springfield Mile winner would love to make it 3 here today. It's Willie McCoy out front. 2nd is Wiles. Let's see who's in 3rd. Here they come. Lap number 1. Expert Twins coming back this direction. Into the first corner. New leader. Looks like the 55 came on through. That is Jake Shoemaker's first time out on the USC Kawasaki. Tuned by James Hart. So it's going to be Shoemaker in the lead. Down the back straightaway. Wiles in 2nd. Willie McCoy back there in 3rd. Down the back straightaway. Wiles takes a look up the inside. He will take the lead into turn number 3. Using that draft pass just like you were supposed to. And lead them into the corner. Here they come off of 4 back this direction. It's Hammer and Hank Henry Wiles. Wiles in lead. Shoemaker in 2nd. Bright orange helmet catching up. Willie McCoy's there. Stevie Bonzi's up there into the 4th spot now. Willie McCoy has to throw it sideways to help slow himself down. We're starting to get a bigger blue groove. One rider slipping up back there in the 5th spot. He loses about 3 spots. Down the back straightaway they go. It is Wiles out front. Shoemaker in 2nd. McCoy 3rd. Bonzi 4th. Danny Kelch in 5th. Jeffrey Carver 6th. Doug Lawrence 7th. Scooter Vernon 8th. Shayna Texter 9th. And Colt Schabaltz rounds out your top 10 as they went by the line last time by. 2 down. Heat race number 3. It's still Wiles out front of this one. Wiles going to lead the freight train off of 4. Down the front straightaway. There's Wiles. Here comes McCoy pulling out early. Shoemaker goes up the inside, takes the lead away. Jake Shoemaker finished 2nd last weekend at the Mega Mile on his own bike, but he's getting his nod to ride the USC James Hart Kawasaki down the back straightaway. It is Shoemaker. Second is Wiles. Willie McCoy is right there. Now McCoy's back in the fourth spot. That means Bonzi's up to third. Bonzi's in the third spot. He's looking around the outside. The Zanotti Harley said, my teammate Coolbeth won a heat race. I'm looking to do the same thing. Coolbeth, I'm sorry, Zanotti racing up number 80. Stevie Bonzi's up to second place. Here they come. Shoemaker has other thoughts in mind. Shoemaker goes up the inside, takes over the lead into turn number one. Slide Wiles back to second. Bonzi's in the third spot, back and forth. Willie McCoy now hits, but Doug Lawrence is up to fourth. Willie McCoy in the fifth spot. Dougie Fresh trying to make the main. Willie McCoy goes up the inside, takes that fourth spot away. Wiles takes the lead back away from Shoemaker. So it's Henry Wiles, Jake Shoemaker, third spot. Here comes Stevie Bonzi. Bonzi shows the wheel up the inside, coming for third. Down the front straightaway, they come back at us. It's Wiles, Shoemaker, Willie McCoy in a fourth spot. Doug Lawrence looked like he got up there in a hurry. Now it looks like he's slipping up just a little bit. Danny Keltz trying to come through on the all yellow leathers. Danny Keltz back there in the sixth spot. So it's Wiles, Coolbeth, Shoemaker, McCoy, Dougie Fresh, Danny Keltz. Jeffrey Carver's now catching up to the leaders. Carver run a little bit higher line going into turn number three. Looks like it's working for him. Coming back this direction, it's still Wiles and Shoemaker battling for the lead. Off of four, coming here, they come to the home stretch. It's Wiles, now Shoemaker pulls out early. Shoemaker to the lead, Wiles back to second, Bonzi's in third, Willie McCoy's in fourth. They're battling for the lead. This is allowing Willie McCoy to start catching up to the leaders once again. Two laps to go, actually about a lap and a half remains now. It's Shoemaker, Wiles, first and second. Bonzi's in the third spot. The bright orange motorcycle, Willie McCoy's caught up to the leaders. Now we got a four-way battle for the lead. Two of these riders will go to the dash. Two, all four riders will go to the main event. White flag is out. One more lap around the Springfield Mile. Here they come. Shoemaker, Wiles, look like Wiles and Bonzi touch going into turn number one. Nobody let off. Bonzi now looks up the inside. Might have cost him a little bit. He tried to duck under the inside of Wiles. They'll take him down the back straightaway. Final lap, a half a lap remaining. Heat race number three. Here comes Henry Wiles. Wiles goes up the inside, takes the lead away from Shoemaker. Bonzi's going to try to come with him. Willie McCoy right there in the fourth spot. Last lap, last corner, checkered flag. Going to fly this time by. Off of turn number four, it is Wiles bringing him off of four. Here they come. Shoemaker's in second. Here comes Bonzi. Great race in all of our heat races. 17, Henry Wiles pulls off the win. So Henry Wiles, your winner. Listen to this, ladies and gentlemen, 0.008. So 0.008ths of a second back to Shoemaker on the 55. Shoemaker gets that second transfer to the dash for cash. So Wiles and Shoemaker. Stevie Bonzi gets the third spot. Willie McCoy gets that fourth and final transfer. Jeff Carver worked his way up to fifth. Doug Lawrence will get sixth, Danny Kelch seventh, Scooter Vernon will get eighth, Shane Extra ninth, Chad Coast will get the 10th spot, Colt Chabot, Aaron Linfors, and Brett Satters rounding out your field. After this interview, we're going to take a 10-minute break, so it's a good time to stretch your legs, grab yourself a souvenir program. They got 50-50 tickets walking around. The class of 79 friends. There's Hammer and Hank Wiles. He's looking for his first career mile victory. If he does that, he will complete the Grand Slam. But he looks like he's pretty good so far. Barry Boone will be down there with the winner here. Again, we're going to take our first scheduled intermission right after this interview, so we'll be back in just a little bit. About a 10-minute break is what they're telling me right now. So let's go trackside. My partner for the sixth year in a row, Barry Boone.
Wow, what a great three-rider battle all the way to the checkered flag. Shoemaker waited just a little too long to make his move, and Hammer and Hank Wiles did it, ladies and gentlemen. Could perhaps on his way to a grand slam. Give it up for national number 17, Hammer and Hank Wiles. Okay, that's what Springfield's all about, man. And you could be on your way to a grand slam. But first, let's talk about that race.
Yeah, it was a great race. You know, I got out front early, pulled a great start. Don's Kawasaki's working great. Woody Kyle's got the motor running awesome. You know, he has all year, but this is a place that it really shines. So, you know, just got out there and got going, playing the chess game, you know, drafting around. And Willie almost made it difficult for me. But I think even if he would have snuck in front of us there, we still would have been able to pull off that win. But I just set it up just right and kind of knew I wanted to lead off turn four. I'd been getting some really good runs off turn four and just so happened to be on the checkered flag. I didn't get that good of a run, and it made it really close. But it's exciting for the fans, exciting for my team. So I just got to thank, you know, everybody. Don's Kawasaki, Schiller's Tree Service, DPC Racing, Bell Helmets. Like I said earlier, Woody Kyle, he's got this thing working real well. I saw we did a number on our tires, so I got Mike Lynch, the head chief mechanic here, checking them out already, and already developing a game plan for me, so that's a good feeling. And J&M Logging, Matt Hieronymus, he's also been a big part of the team this year. Tim Trowbridge and Sun Home Builders, Gene Gale Cummings, and everybody else that's helping out with the program.
Because we have a little more time, I want to follow up real quick. Over the years, we've seen you run well on the miles on Harley-Davidsons. We've seen you run on the Ducati. You've ridden a little bit of everything. But this Kawasaki just seems to be a really good fitment for you.
Yeah, I think so. I'd never really been able to get on one really good Harley here at Springfield. And that was one time I got to ride it, and I had it sitting on the front row. But, it's all those little things that you got to dial in and fine-tune. And this is the first time we rolled out this motorcycle today, and it's already a better package than what we had before. So to be able to come in here with a brand new chassis and, win a Springfield Mile heat race is pretty awesome.
The fans are going to a quick break. Scotty and I have been talking about the Grand Slam for you a lot lately, especially today. What would that mean to you to get the Grand Slam after having won every other type of discipline?
Well, it'd mean a lot, and it's going to happen. It's not a matter of if, but when. And we're finally on the right track, finally got the group of guys around me that I need, that are going to help go forward with the program. And that's a big component to having a team. It's got to be everybody in the team going towards the same direction. And, it's going to be a good feeling when it happens, obviously. It's going to be a dream come true, really.
Well, after winning 10 consecutive Peoria TTs in 2014, to come back and get the Grand Slam in 2014 would pretty much give you a reason to go celebrate in the offseason. I know you said thanks to everybody. We all done on that?
Yeah, I think so.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, national number 17, Hammerin' Hank Wiles. What a guy. What a guy. What a great race we saw right there. Hollywood, turn it back up to you. We'll take a brief break in the action, and we'll be back shortly.